Speaking of a transparent environment for business, let us then briefly review the OECD's recent investment policy review document. What do you think?
Why not? This is the first time that the OECD touched upon the investment challenges, opportunities, potential, and also suggested a very fresh view of the history that Georgia's liberalization of the economy and the reforms targeting FDI specifically have brought to Georgia up to this point.
Let us then summarize briefly some of the points that me and you think are important. And let me start with the following point. A comprehensive investment policy statement would help align all actors behind a joint vision and foster synergies between investment, exports, and enterprise and innovation promotion. Such is an assumption of OECD's recent investment policy review for Georgia. According to OECD, several institutions promote investment and actively pursue investors. While this is in itself is not a weakness, the lack of strong coordination, starting with a single government focal point for investors, leads to inefficiencies, duplication of efforts, and confusion for investors. The review identifies those areas of Georgia's investment promotion framework which could be threatened. Foremost among these are the ongoing efforts to reinforce the independence, accountability, and capacity of the country's judiciary. Other important challenges include ensuring the intellectual property rights are enforced effectively, realizing universal land registration, and continuing to improve the legal and institutional infrastructure that supports alternative dispute resolution services.
Yes, a very important point. Indeed, my focus will be on the agriculture sector, Georgi, and partially unemployment, since most self-employed people are concentrated exactly in this very sector. Attracting investment in Georgia's agricultural and food value chain, collectively accounting for 10% of GDP and 44% of employment, has the potential to generate substantial benefits for key sectors. Such was another assumption from the OECD's recent investment policy review for Georgia. According to OECD, in the past decade since the liberalization of Georgia's economy, the most significant structural change is the decline in value added for agriculture. Deriving from mainly ILO's assessments, the review argues that the agriculture accounted for more than one-third of GDP following independence, while it now contributes just 8%. However, this decline was not accompanied by a reallocation of labor, and agriculture remains the country's largest employer, absorbing 42% of the workforce in 2019. And another point that's worth mentioning here is also that, according to OECD, while urban poverty has more than halved since 2004, rural poverty increased following liberalization reforms, only declining markedly since 2012. However, rural poverty reduction appears primarily due to increases in state transfers and other social assistance rather than job opportunities.
So you mentioned that Investors Council was actively involved in the exercise as well as discussions of the results of this very important policy document and investments.
Yes, Georgi, you're totally right, and our viewers now have the chance to see what are some of the reforms that the Investors Council has been working in 2020. A short review of the year from Georgi Cherkezishvili, head of the Investors Council Secretariat.
Let us first of all sum up the year of 2020, the year of uncertainty, as called by many today due to COVID-19. What did you have to change in the agenda of Investors Council, and also what are some of the challenges and opportunities that you see in drawing FDI into this country?
2020 year was a really very, very, very challenging and difficult year for all the world. Investor Council Secretariat is also affected these challenges, but we had a very productive and very active year in regards of the reforms and then in regards of fulfilling our mandate mandate, which is to provide the recommendation and provide a policy dialogue between the private sector, government, and international organizations.
So what are some of the priorities that COVID-19 has brought to the table?
The effect of the COVID-19 of the companies and, you know, the business society in the country, it's affected, and in the we, the Investor Council, starting from the very beginning of this pandemic situation in the country, we started a dialogue between the government and the private sector and donor organizations, started a survey of the business members of the Investor Council and in the business community in the country, and asked Pricewaterhouse to prepare this study and its survey of this impact. This first phase was covered April 2020, and recently in October we provided the second phase of this study, and then it showed that what's their business real problems, what are their major challenges.
Name some of the challenges and opportunities and expectations, just
major challenge was a decreasing demand, and second was the some effect of the value chains and the, of the some access to some distribution channels in regards of the keeping personnel, for example, for the big companies, it was relatively more stable, and also to refinancing or getting access to the finances on rescheduling existing liabilities towards the banks. Around 75% of the companies they used for restructuring their existing liabilities towards the banks.
Back to the reforms part. So, what should foreign direct investors expect of Georgia after post-COVID period, when all the studies, all the IFIs, all the donors, everyone is speaking that competition for FDI will be much higher than it was before?
Yeah, definitely competition will be high, especially such countries like Georgia is. Our members' experience provided quite intensive recommendations to the government. We are very close cooperation in the attraction of FDI with Enterprise Georgia. We are working also closely on the elaborating their FDA strategy, and we recently all members had a positive feedback on newly initiated FDI grants scheme. We have separate working groups for the legal frameworks of the development of the capital market, the development of the energy sector, pharmaceutical sector, and then all the challenges in different fields of the economy. And then we are providing recommendations to the government, and also working on legislative or some steering committees, and then providing all the recommendations and inputs from our members.
Yes. So what I know, we might get new updates on the reforms on leasing, on factoring, on securities. Could you please name some of these, and why do you think that these are crucial for the post-COVID period?
Access to the capital and alternative financial sources is crucial for the companies, especially post-COVID situation, especially when the crisis is there. We are working very actively in different stakeholders in regards of the development of the leasing strategy of the country, working closely with the working group of the factoring operations, working also on the securitization and in the many other initiatives. And you are familiar that this year government approved the law on investment funds, and then we are expecting this development of the capital market will support investment climate in Georgia.
Thank you for taking our questions.
Thank you very much. Thank you.